God our Father and the Lord Jesus Christ be with you.
And also with you.
I will go to the altar of God.
Even to God, my joy and gladness.
Our help is in the name of the Lord.
Who has made heaven and earth.
My brothers and sisters, to prepare ourselves to celebrate the sacred mysteries, let us call to mind our sins. We confess to God Almighty,
the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit, that we have sinned in thought, word, and deed, to our own grievous fault. For this we ask God to have mercy on us. Almighty God, have mercy on us, forgive us all our sins, and deliver us from evil. Confirm and strengthen us in all goodness, and bring us to life everlasting. Amen.
May the Almighty and merciful Lord grant you pardon and remission of all your sins, time for true repentance, amendment of life, and the grace and comfort of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
It is the Lord Yahweh who speaks. I shall look. Bring back the strayed, bandage the wounded, and make the weak strong. I shall watch over the fat and healthy. I shall be a true shepherd to them. This is the word of the Lord.
Thank you.
121, beginning at the 15th verse. After the meal, Jesus said to Simon Peter, "Simon, son of John, do you love me more than these others do?" He answered, "Yes, Lord, you know I love you. I tell you most solemnly, when you were young, you put on your own belt and walked where you might. But when you grow old, you will stretch out your hands, and somebody else will put a belt round you and take you where you would rather not go." In these words, he indicated the kind of death by which Peter would give glory to God. After this, he said, "Follow me." This is the gospel of Christ.
Not another letter from Paul. The early Christians used to cry, "The and approach and deliver the rest. For Paul was one of the world's most famous writer of letters. In his early days, he was called Saul. But on the road to Damascus, he saw the light and had a change of life. He became Paul and gave up persecuting Christians and became a missionary. He set off on his Far Trek 1, Far Trek 2, and Far Trek 3, like a captain of the ancient Kirk. In the words of the 20th century's fitting definitive, to boldly go where no Christian man had gone before. Paul is the one we in the church usually quote when we want to win arguments, especially against other Christians. For some, Paul is considered a true saint, a man who spent his life setting up churches and giving advice to people on how to live the Christian life. Yet if we really read it, the letters of Paul, we start to see a very different sort of character. Paul's prose is as prickly and fresh as if you'd caught your nail on a hand, your hand on a nail this morning. It's that sharp, it's that prickly. He dictates very furiously, often in a very angry mood. He forgets his place so badly in his letters that the people who actually write them down can't resolve his sentences. He makes jokes about his enemies and uses sometimes the most specious logic to force a point. Paul is a strange, mystical man, and according to legend, looked it, bow-legged, with a balding head, and eyebrows that drew straight across the nose. I'm all right so far. In his letter to the Galatians, Paul writes, "Among you, there is no such thing as Jew and Greek, slave and freeman, male and female, for you are all one in Christ." Yet, in his letter to the Corinthians, Paul writes, "As in all congregations of God's people, women should keep silent at the meeting. They have no permission to talk, but should keep their place as the Lord directs. If there is something they want to know, they can ask their husbands at home. It is a shocking thing for a woman to talk at the meeting." Who says St. Paul is irrelevant? What comes out clearly for me is the humanity of Peter and Paul, the sense of movement, of being on the journey towards God. They may not get things right all the time, but they are prepared to change and travel on. Shirley stands in the centre of her humanity, a sense of compassion, sense of joy and love of life, as Shirley bounces along the road in her leathers. Perhaps for some of you, it came as a great surprise to see your new curate flying down the street on her mean machine. Although I do have to say that I remember when it was no more than a small moped. She didn't quite put the same sort of dash. But many of you already will have experienced and felt Shirley's concern for others and her deep love of God with her own inimitable style. For Shirley, along with Peter and Paul, is not afraid to take risks for God. For Shirley, like the rest of us, is on a journey. The journey that always leads to new discoveries about ourselves and about this God whom we worship. This is what makes the life of a disciple so exhilarating and at times so daunting. Yet Shirley does not stand at the altar in her own power. She stands there in the power of the Holy Spirit. The Eucharist is at the very heart of our journey. But perhaps sometimes we approach the Eucharist perhaps a bit too glibly. She began to cry. Afterwards, she apologized. "I'm sorry, it always affects me like this. It seems to touch something at the very heart of me." In a very real way, she had brought home to me again the truth. The truth behind the action. To receive the body and blood in a Eucharist is not a magic pill. It is not to zap us if we are open to hear what God has to say to us. If we come with open hearts and minds, then perhaps we will be surprised. But be warned. We celebrate Peter and Paul not as supermen, perfect saints, but as human beings who got things wrong sometimes. At the end of the day, we are called to be human, called to be ourselves. We will get things wrong. But if we accept that, if we acknowledge that, then we can move forward. And like Peter and Paul, glimpse something of the living God. And in the process, perhaps pass this on to those around us. Jesus said to Peter, "Do you love me?" As we come to the Eucharist, what is our answer? And I have spoken in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Yeah.
Dickinson, Eric Fox, David Taylor, Isabel McGillivray, Bill Ridgway, Ian Stevens, Ken Timms, among those who have died recently, we remember Al Bates, Dahl Dixon, Bert Lister, Sid Guntry. And among those whose year's mind occurs at this time, we especially remember Denise Ellis. Through Jesus, whom we confess as Lord, we give thanks and praise to the Father, calling on him who is judge of all. Father, your kingdom come.
Father, your kingdom come.
For all the peoples of the world, that they may know you as the God of peace. For the nations, for leaders and governments, that integrity may mark all their dealings. For communities torn by dissension and strife, that your forgiveness may bring them healing. We pray to you, O Lord.
Father,
for the sick and injured in body and spirit, that your healing love may be their reality. For the anxious, the lonely, the bereaved, that consolation and peace may be theirs. We pray to you, O Lord. For the church, your household and family, that she may be firm in the confession of her hope. For Robert and David, our bishops, and for all who wear Christ's name, that their lives may proclaim your glory. We pray to you, O Lord.
Father, your kingdom come.
For those who are separated from us by death, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, St. Lawrence, St. Peter, St. Paul, and all the saints, theirs may be a kingdom which is unshakable. We pray to you, O Lord.
Father, your kingdom come.
O God of peace, who brought again from the dead our Lord Jesus, that great shepherd of the sheep, make us perfect in all goodness, to do your will, and to be what you would have us be. Through him to whom be glory forever, Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen.
Thank you.
Blessed be God forever.
Blessed are you, Lord God, all creation. Through your goodness we have this wine to offer, fruit of the vine and work of human hands. It will become our spiritual drink.
Blessed be God forever.
Thank you.
We break this bread to share in the body of Christ. Jesus is the Lamb of God who takes away the sins of the world. Happy are those who are called to his Son.
Lord, I am not worthy that you should come under my roof, but speak the word only, and my soul shall be
Thank you.
Go in peace. Go in the peace of Christ.
Thanks be to God.
Thank you.
rejoicing at his mighty resurrection and glorious ascension, and looking for his coming in glory, we celebrate this memorial of our redemption. We thank you for counting us worthy to stand in your presence and serve you. We bring before you this bread and this cup. We pray you to accept this our duty and service, a spiritual sacrifice of praise and thanksgiving. Send your Holy Spirit on your people and gather into one in your kingdom all who share this one bread and one cup, so that we, in the company of all the saints, may praise and glorify you forever. Through him from whom all good things come, Jesus Christ, our Lord. By whom, and with whom, and in whom, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all honor and glory be yours, Almighty Father, forever and ever.
Amen.
As our Savior Christ has commanded us, we are bold to pray.
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power and the glory, forever and ever. Amen.
We break this bread to share in the body of Christ. Jesus is the Lamb of God who takes away the sins of the world. Happy are those who are called to his Son.
Lord, I am not worthy that you should come under my roof, but speak the word only, and my soul shall be
healed. Thank you. say together, Almighty God,
we thank you for giving us the body and blood of your Son, Jesus Christ, to remain in our souls of promise, to be a living sacrifice. Send us out now.
Go in the peace of Christ.